everyone. In this video, we are going to talk about the relationship between the conceptual framework and the hypothesis. Creating a conceptual framework is a big challenge for a lot of people, even when they have written good hypothesis, effective hypothesis. So let's start with the basic concept. What is conceptual framework? A conceptual framework presents what a researcher expects as an outcome of the research or the study. It basically graphically maps out or presents the variables and their relationships in a diagram. So when we have a conceptual framework, we have different kind of hypotheses that we are summarizing over there. And we're going to talk about these different type of hypotheses presented in a conceptual framework: direct effects, simple mediation, serial mediation, parallel mediation, simple moderation, and then moderated mediation, or we also call it conditional mediation. Remember, whenever we are writing hypotheses, they always have to start from the IVs to the DVs. Even when you have moderators and mediators in between, we start the hypothesis from the IV and we end the hypothesis on the DV. Let's look into the direct relationship first. Now, we draw such kind of a conceptual framework when we only have direct relationships in our hypothesis. And I can show you these hypotheses. This is how the hypothesis would be written. Informativeness has a positive effect on acceptance. You can see there's a direct relationship. Entertainment has a positive effect on ad acceptance. Irritation has a negative effect. You will note that we have negative, positive on the relationships or the arrows that we have drawn from the variable from the IV to the DV. Now, look at the simple mediation over here. Now, we would draw this kind of a conceptual framework when we have such kind of a hypothesis. Ad value positively mediates the positive effect of entertainment on the ad acceptance. You can see that ad value in the middle, right over here. We have ad value in the middle, and it is mediating the positive effect of entertainment on the ad acceptance. So we start from the middle, we start from the mediator, and then we talk about what it intervenes, what it mediates. Same as this, we have the first hypothesis, that is ad value positively mediates the positive effect of informativeness on the ad acceptance. And this one is a little different, the last one. Ad value positively mediates the negative effect of informativeness on ad acceptance. If you remember, even our direct hypothesis was negative, and this irritation to ad value, that is negative. So that's the reason why we are saying that it is mediating the negative relationship between these two variables. So this is how we would talk about the simple mediation. Now, let's say if we have a serial mediation, this is how it would be presented. Our, we have three IVs, but we have two mediators in between these IVs. So it's like informativeness to add value to the ad attitude towards the ads, and then moving on towards the ad acceptance. So how would we write this? Add value and attitude towards ads serially and positively mediate, mediate the positive effect of entertainment on ad acceptance. Now, similarly, add value and attitude towards the ad serially and positively mediate positive effect of informativeness on ad acceptance. And this one is different, like before. Add value and attitude toward the ad serially and negatively mediate the effect of informativeness on the ad acceptance. So this is how the serial mediation would be written. Now let's move on towards the, now we'll look at the parallel mediation. Now parallel mediation would be written in a very simple way, because we are not going to talk about the parallel mediation. We are just going to talk about that informativeness relationship with the ad acceptance is mediated by ad attitude once, and then we will talk about the mediation by ad value. So it's like, you know, there would be two different hypotheses that we would write for one mediator each. Remember, we never write a hypothesis that is from IV to DV or DV to IV. We write a complete hypothesis that is starting from the IV and moving on towards the DV. So this is about the parallel mediation. In the same manner, you can write the hypotheses for the entertainment and the irritation. Now, when there is a moderation, this is how our model looks like. We have IVs over here and we have a DV on the right-hand side, and the moderator is in the middle. You can see the arrows are connected with the paths. They are not connected with the variables. So it's very clearly indicating that the moderator has an effect on the relationship. So this is how we are going to write the hypothesis for this. H moderates the positive effect of entertainment on the ad acceptance. H moderates the positive effect of informativeness on the ad acceptance. Now, this one is negative. You remember, we have a negative relationship from irritation to ad acceptance. So, H moderates the negative effect of informativeness on the ad acceptance. So, this is what we have over here when we have simple moderation. But when we have a moderated mediation effect, like you have a mediated path, and that is moderated by another variable, the hypothesis for such a model is a little different. Like H moderates positive effect of entertainment on ad acceptance mediated by ad value. Like, see, we have all the three variables over here. This is our moderator. It moderates the positive effect of entertainment on ad acceptance that is mediated by the ad value. So we have mediator right at the end. You can write this hypothesis in whatever manner you would like to formulate, but this is one of the ways in which you can write. Similarly, this is one is for informativeness, and have a look at this one. This one is for the irritation effect. So this was a video where we were talking about how a hypothesis translates into the conceptual framework, or how you can graphically represent the hypothesis that you have developed in your literature review. Hope this video would help you create good conceptual frameworks and write good hypotheses. Hope to see you again in other videos. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel.